This is Polar Care Cube, one of the newest innovations in motorized cold therapy. This system is lightweight, compact, and easy to use. Be sure to use the Polar Care Cube as prescribed by a licensed healthcare professional, including how often and long to apply and when to take breaks from cold therapy. While there are many benefits to the use of cold therapy, a word of caution. Cold therapy systems can be cold enough to seriously injure the skin, so be sure to follow these instructions carefully. Certain medical conditions make cold-induced injury more likely, so before you apply the Polar Care system, it's critical to carefully review and assess your patient with regard to each contraindication and risk factor noted on the product insert. The Polar Care Cube consists of four parts: the unit, the power supply, the pad, and the insulation barrier. Polar Care units come with body part-specific pads. This one is a multi-use pad, which can be used on various core body parts, while this one is for the knee. For patient safety, it is essential to use the pad designed specifically for the body part being treated. To apply the pad, always use an insulation barrier between the pad and the skin, like a Breg Polar dressing, Webril, Curlix, cast padding, or an elastic bandage. Don't let any part of the pad touch the skin directly. If the patient is wearing a sterile dressing that doesn't completely cover the skin under the pad, use an additional barrier. With the insulation barrier in place, if using the Polar pad, apply with the smooth side up. When using a wrap-on pad, apply with the blue side up. Use the elastic straps to hold the pad in place. For information on how to properly apply a specific pad, watch the pad module that details your specific pad. Next, fill the unit with cold water, then ice, not the other way around, to ensure you maximize the ice time. Generally speaking, larger ice means longer ice time. Using the ice shown here, the water in the cube will stay under 55 degrees Fahrenheit for 6 to 8 hours. Once filled, place the lid on the cube with the hose pointed away from the product descriptor and lock the lid into place with a handle. The next step is very important. Before connecting the pad to the unit, push down on the two metal tabs. You'll hear each click when you push them down. Firmly push the unit and the pad together. You will see the two metal tabs pop back up and hear the clicks. If you force the unit and the pad together without depressing the metal tabs first, you may damage the connector. Plug the power supply into the DC jack and plug the other end of the cord into a power outlet. Once it has power, the unit will immediately begin circulating water through the pad. The cube is extremely quiet, so you may not hear the pump unless you get close. The average surface temperature of the insulation barrier over the pad will be between 45 to 55 degrees Fahrenheit for pads intended for use on core body parts and 50 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit for pads intended for use on extremities. In the unlikely event water leaks from any part of the unit, pad, or connection, stop using the unit and contact your local Breg sales representative or Breg customer care. Be sure to inspect the patient's skin under the pad as prescribed, typically every 1 to 2 hours. You should be able to inspect the skin by lifting the pad and insulation barrier. Discontinue use and contact the physician if your patient experiences any adverse reactions, such as burning, itching, blisters, discoloration welts, increased pain, swelling or redness, other changes in skin appearance, or any other reactions that have been discussed with the physician. To stop or refill the unit, unplug the unit from the electrical source. Disconnect the pad from the unit by depressing the two metal tabs and gently pull the connectors apart. The pad will seal itself and won't leak. Some dripping during release is normal. Turn the lid upside down and place it on a flat surface so extra water gathers in the lid. Then refill the unit with cold water, then ice. If you need a reminder regarding how to use the Polar Care Cube, refer to the operating instructions printed on the wraparound label or the product insert in the pouch on the side of the unit. Upon discharge, Augment your verbal instructions to the patient or caregiver by showing where these instructions are located. There's also a patient video that can be accessed by scanning the QR code on the operating instruction label with a QR code-enabled smartphone or by visiting bregg.com/PCC. Bregg's Polar Care units are very reliable. With proper setup and maintenance, our customers experience very few difficulties. In the event you run into an issue, let's go over a few tips. If at any point the pad is not getting cold, take the following steps, one at a time, until the issue is resolved. 1. Make sure the power outlet is working and the plug is fully engaged with the unit. 2. Lift the lid and make sure there's plenty of ice left and the water level is at or above the indicated line. 3. Replace the lid and ensure there are no kinks in the blue insulation hose. 4. Raise the unit off the ground and place it on a table or chair to reduce back pressure. 5. Decrease the tension of any bandages or straps securing the pad. 6. Disconnect the pad from the unit. Rotate the connection 180 degrees, then reconnect the pad to the unit. If excess condensation appears on the surface of the pad, wrap the outer surface with an ACE bandage or similar material to prevent warm, humid air from coming into contact with the pad. Also, remove any warming blanket that traps warm, humid air above the surface of the pad. If you're unable to resolve an issue using the steps within this video, don't hesitate to contact your local Bregg sales representative or Bregg Customer Care at 1-800-897-BREGG. That's 1-800-897-2734. Thank you for choosing the Polar Care Cube.